What's good? So, I'm not gonna make like an intro because this is gonna be a makeup collection video. So, like, why would I spend time making an intro, like a 5-second intro? I don't see the point, but I look crazy. Look at my nails. I look sick. Oh my god, what is this? Guys, I look fucking gross, but yeah, this is gonna be a makeup collection video. I don't know, I just see people make these all the time, and I'm like, wow, I really like watching those types of videos, let me make one. So, that's what this is gonna be, so, see ya guys. Okay, so I put my phone on my tripod so that I'm able to show y'all what are in specific drawers, because I'm gonna start these two and then go down. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with this drawer. I put like my single shadows, not like single shadows, but like individual shadow pots in these two drawers. So I'll start off with this one. These are all of my ColourPop shadows. I have them underneath, so I have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, and this one, but yeah, these are just, like, my single shadows. Oh, shit, bitch. Nothing crazy important. I mean, I love me a, that's my mother. I love me a good ColourPop shadow, as you can probably tell. Like, look at that, it's beautiful. I really like this one. I like bronzy, like golden brown shades like that. But yeah, these are just my ColourPop or whatever. And then in this one, there's more like random things, like single shadow pots. Like I have this, what is this? This L'Oreal Infallible eyeshadow. It looks like this. I've had this since like, I can't even fucking open it. But it's like this, and it's this shade. I used to flip my shit over these when I like first started getting into makeup, because I thought they were so pigmented and so amazing. I mean, they are pigmented, but now that I know makeup, I know there's a lot better things. Then I just have this random ass blush. Let me open this, that I got in an Ipsy like last year. It's kind of like glowy, as you can see. It's really pretty. Why do I not use this? Oh, I need to use this more. But, okay, let me stop going so slow. I have a NYX, I fucking dropped it. A NYX Tame and Frame Brow Pomade. I have some fucking NYX individual shadows back here, F3, the prismatic ones. I have this, like, random ass individual shadow I got in an Ipsy that I don't use. And then I just have, like, a few other, like, random things in here. Nothing crazy. But, yes, those are where I put those types of products. Next drawer is lip items. I'm gonna move you guys over so you can see, so I can show you guys better. I moved it so you guys can see, the products better. As you can see, I like reds and, like, berry colors and, like, deeper colors. I'm not a big, like, pink lip person. I don't like pink lipsticks or, like, nudes, like so many, like too many nudes. Like these are like lip glosses, but like liquid lipsticks I don't really like. Oh, don't mind this. I got this like 2 years ago because I thought I was the shit and I never use it, so it's just in there. But anyways, I'm gonna show you guys some of the things. I have some NYX butter glosses. I have a Dose of Color like a lipstick. I have like a NYX liquid lipstick. I have a NYX butter lipstick. I have another butter gloss back here. Is this the one? No. There was one that Tina Halana recommended, and that's my bitch, so I bought it. I think it's this one. Yeah, Praline, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, this is the one she recommended, and honestly, I love it. But yeah, I have these liquid lipsticks that I just got. Actually, I didn't just get them, but I just randomly found them in my closet, and they were still in the bag that I bought them. They're like these LA Color liquid lipsticks that I got at Family Dollar. I haven't used any, and they're all still closed. I haven't even opened them yet, but I have those. I have like a random NYX lip gloss. have an Anastasia Lip Lipstick, this Infallible L'Oreal Lipstick, I have some Milani, these two Milani Lip Lipsticks, which I fucking love. I have this NARS Lip Gloss, another Anastasia Lipstick, some just like random things. I have some ColourPop, Wet n Wild down there, some MAC, just random shit, random lipsticks and stuff. I used to be like the biggest lipstick person. I used to wear like a lipstick every day, but now I'm starting to gravitate more towards glosses. I really love glosses. I really love the Butter Glosses by NYX. They are spectacular. Next door is like eyeliners, mascaras, brow gel shit, like random stuff like that. So I'm gonna move y'all down some more. Oh fuck, bitch, I don't even know if this goes down any further. Okay, it's just gonna have to be like this. I mean, I think you guys can still see it. Okay, this is gonna work. This is gonna work. I have like my mascaras and shit in here. So I have like this Wet n Wild mascara, an e.l.f. eyeliner. Oh fuck, an e.l.f. mascara. I have two of the e.l.f. Brow pencil things. I have a Tarte mascara, another Wet n Wild mascara, this It Cosmetics brow thing that I got in a BoxyCharm and I really don't like it. I have this Urban Decay mascara, Marc Jacobs mascara, this fucking Wet n Wild brow gel, another Wet n Wild mascara, a Tarte eyeliner, another e.l.f. eyeliner, just like, you know, just a majority of, like, I have mostly mascaras in this little thing. I have this little Gimme Brow by Benefit. See, I just have like a majority of different brands, mostly mascaras and eyeliners. But I would go in depth, but I just have so much that I don't want to make this video too fucking long and boring and stupid, so I'm not gonna like do that. But yeah, the next drawer is, what is this drawer? This is like miscellaneous things, like random shit that I don't really know where else to put. Just like random shit. Like I have two of these liquid eyeshadow things by e.l.f. I have this Stellar setting powder. I have some Hard Candy glitters. I have a fucking Butter London, a random Butter London lipstick. I have the Rimmel Brow This Way. A stick highlighter by Maybelline. As you can tell, I'm really fucking tired, but I wanted to put out a video, so yeah. I have this e.l.f. eyebrow shit thing, which is way too light for my eyebrows, and I didn't even realize it until I bought it home and opened it, so I'm probably just gonna give this to someone, to be quite honest, because I can't use it. It's too light, and I just used it one time, so whatever. I have three Wet n Wild blushes, really good blushes. I have Wet n Wild pressed face powder thing. So I just have random shit in this drawer that I really didn't know where else to put, so I just stuffed it all in this drawer. And I got both of these acrylic, this one, I have another one over there, but I got both these acrylic organizers from Amazon. I can put the link in the description below. I will, because honestly, they're really good quality, and they're like $20 each, and they're like really sturdy and good quality. So I will do that. I will do that favor and put it in the description bar so you guys, I also have this Milk Blur Stick. I thought it was really cool because I like the packaging. It's super tiny, but I got it. It's just like, it's a lot of product. I've used it like maybe like 6 times, and it still like has like a bunch of product, but I like it. It reminds me of the Professional by Benefit. I like it a lot. And then this last drawer is also more miscellaneous things. Things that I actually have to throw away. Like I should throw this away. I should throw this away. I should throw this away, but yeah, I have to clean it out. So I just have like my Anastasia Dip Brow, which is too ashy. It's literally in the color ash brown, and I'm just retarded. And I bought it because my name is Ashley, so I thought I was the shit. Oh, ash brown, I'll get this, but it's literally ash. Literally, it's gross. I don't know why I bought this. It was $18, and I can't return it because I ordered it on Ulta, and I don't even. And then I have my, actually these are kind of similar in color, like this Dip Brow by e.l.f. It's not even Dip Brow, it's a pomade. It's the e.l.f. brow and eyeliner cream. It looks a lot like the ash brown Anastasia, but it's a lot like, I don't know, this one doesn't look as ashy on, but they swatch like basically the same color. I don't know how to explain it, but whatever. And then I have like this little mini Becca highlighter that's broken, so I can't open it, but I love it. It's really pretty. It's in the color opal. I really like this. I'm gonna buy the full product. I probably will. I have this NYX eyeshadow base, and I just have some random other shit that I really don't care about, so we're gonna move on over here. Here I just have my brushes and my glasses. Don't look at them, I'm a blind bitch. But I mostly just have my brushes. I just have my brushes. I actually should take some of these out and put them in the other side because they're all stuffed. Put some over here. Oh shit. I'm not that interesting of a person, so I don't have like any like cool like MAC brushes or cool Morphe brushes. I have like one Morphe brush that I got in like a BoxyCharm and I don't even know where the hell it is. But most of my brushes are ColourPop, Wet n Wild, NYX, BH Cosmetics, Real Techniques, a bunch of brushes that I got on Amazon like 2 years ago, e.l.f. brushes, and just random brushes that I've accumulated over the years that I haven't washed once because I'm a nasty bitch. Wow, I sound like Tana Mojo. But yeah, just random shit. And then these are my little face brushes right now. Like, I barely have any because I'm stupid. But I mean, I should really start buying more brushes and cleaning my brushes because it's fucking gross, honestly, and I'm just nasty. I have this big powder brush. I have this Wet n Wild powder brush, this random fan brush, this random contour brush, another Wet n Wild contour brush. I have this Wet n Wild highlight brush. I have this e.l.f. foundation stippling brush. I have, oh fuck, this brush that I got on like Wish, and also this brush that I got on Wish. But yeah, those are my face brushes. I got this little rose gold thing from Walmart for $1, and then I got this little acrylic thing from Walmart for like $5. I don't even remember, to be honest. And this is my mirror. Oh goodness, don't look at me, I'm fat, gross. Okay, then over here I'm gonna move you guys to this side. Over here I just have another acrylic organizer with like this top on it from one of my old acrylic organizers that I just kept the top for my lipsticks. I have like some like random lipsticks that are literally collecting dust because I don't use them. I have some Milani up here. Pretty sure this is Maybelline. Yes, Maybelline right here and Maybelline right here. I have this little Smashbox gloss, two Wet n Wild highlighters, some glitters, and just random things. And then down here are my first two drawers. In this drawer, I have more Wet n Wild. Okay, let me back you guys up so you guys can see. In this drawer, I have more Wet n Wild single shadows. I have 2, 4, 6, 6 single shadows, 2 more highlighters, and 2 loose highlighters. These are more new ones that I just got, so they're nice and clean. These are 2 of my favorite ones. Oh, shit. And then I have 2 loose highlighters. Oh, my God. This is a dewdrop. Oh, my God. Look at that. It's fucking stunning. Okay. And then I have 2 of their pressed highlighters. This one and this one. And I have 2 more up there. But that's that drawer. And then this drawer are just some of my fave glosses at the moment. This box is empty. It just held one of the glosses, but it's so pretty, so I just wanted to keep it. It held this gloss. It's a Becca gloss. I got this on sale for $11 on Sephora. And then I have these 3 glosses that I got from Five Below. And they're honestly so pretty. I have more that are in my purse. And they just look like this. I mean, shit. They just look like this. They're super like pearlescent and they have a reflect on them and they're super pretty. And then I just have this clear gloss that's not that clear because of lipstick I got from like Family Dollar. I have a ColourPop lipstick that I haven't tried yet, and then a random little Maybelline Shine Shot top coat thing. But yeah, like some random glosses that I just keep here. And then this first drawer are primers and setting sprays. I just have the Hard Candy Matte Sheer Envy setting spray. I can't do anything, literally. I'm the grossest person ever. I have the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Natural Finish setting spray. I have the Dr. Brandt Pores No More Luminizer Primer. This is so expensive, and to be honest, I barely fucking use it. It's like $30. But yeah, I got it in a BoxyCharm. And then I have this little mini sample size of the Professional that I got like 3 months ago. I still have some. I really like this. Then I have the e.l.f. Makeup Mist and Set Setting Spray. And then I just have my e.l.f. Mineral Infused Face Primer. Next drawer is my favorite drawer. It's all, this one. It's all highlighter. Oh my god, most beautiful thing to exist. I have this NYX Duo Chromatic Highlighter. This is like kind of dark, but it's really pretty. It's like orangey, goldish. I really like it. I have this little e.l.f. highlighter in the shade Blushed Gems. It's really pretty. I have two Wet n Wild highlighters. These are like the most basic things ever. If you have a Wet n Wild highlighter, you probably have one of these. It's just Precious Petals and Crown of My Canopy. Really, really good highlighters. And then I have two ColourPop compact highlighters. This one is in the shade, doesn't even have the shade names on it, but I just have this like white one. And then I have like this deep bronzy gold one. Over here, I just have this L'Oreal foiled highlighter. Look at this. Like, do you see this? It's the most pretty thing I've ever had in my life. And I use this as like a highlight topper. Like, I usually pair it up with this highlighter. It's the Milani highlighter in the shade Glowing or something like that. I don't know. But I usually put this on and then I put this over it. This is in the shade Gilded Gold. Highly, highly recommend. If you're a woman of color like myself, that would look fucking beautiful on you. And then I just have this fucking Caucasian ass highlighter that I just got for a birthday present through Sephora. It's a Tarte highlighter in the shade Exposed Highlight. I fucking hate this highlighter. It's extremely ashy and weird. It's extremely textured, as you can see. You can tell that this is textured. It emphasizes your pores, like everything. And I hate it. I wish that fucking broke, to be honest. But I just don't have the balls or the guts to throw it away because it is expensive. So, I mean, I could use it as like an eyeshadow or something. That would be fine. But like on my face, it just looks ugly and textured and ugly. And then I have this Hard Candy highlighter that I really, really like. It has like three individual shades in it. I use this gold shade on the side the most. Really pretty. I have the Sephora Golden Hour highlighter. That's just, it's just gold, literally gold. I love gold highlighters. They work really well on my skin tone. And then lastly, I just have this Wet n Wild highlighter in the shade Sangria Castles. Let me open it. This is really pretty. It was like a cheetah print thing, but look. Really pretty. I love it. But yeah, those are my highlighters. And then this drawer is just my foundations and concealers. I love concealer so much. I have my favorite, which is the Milani Concealer Perfect 2-in-1 foundation. I have the True Match Lumi foundation by L'Oreal. I have two of the Fit Me foundations. I love these so much. They're normal to oily skin. Highly recommend. They're like $5 at like Walmart. And then I have 2, 3, 4 of the, let me straighten them out. 4 of the LA Girl Pro Concealers. I sometimes use these as like a foundation if I don't want like a heavy, heavy look. But yeah, I really like these. I have a NYX concealer. A Wet n Wild concealer, which I really, really like, and then just an Anastasia Beverly Hills concealer. It for my desk part. Now we're gonna move on to this part. Oh my god, it's gonna be a long video. I apologize. I actually just popped on my flashlight so you guys can, like, my phone light flash, whatever. I don't know how to talk. So you guys can see because my room doesn't have the best lighting, so. Yes, so this is like a random candle that my friend got me for my birthday. And then this is just like a bunch of hair products that no one really cares about. Let me move you guys over. So just a bunch of hair products that no one cares about. But then I have some makeup in these. I have this random like single shadow. I have a single shadow by e.l.f. I have this Tarte blush. I have a Milani blush. And I have this like little Tarte bronzer thing. And then down here I just have a Milani like foundation thing, a highlighter, and an e.l.f. setting powder. I have a Tarte little palette and a face powder by Black Radiance, I think. I don't know the brand. I have my Real Techniques sponge. And then I just have some like random little color, I mean, not ColourPop, Wet n Wild palettes. And then over here, I have my little acrylic organizer with the rest of like my liquid lipsticks in it. These first two rows are all Wet n Wild cat, liquid cat, whatever, suede. Tattoo shit, I'm tired, holy shit. Except for this one isn't. And then this row is all Line Crime, and this is all these three, and this one is Wet n Wild, I mean, fuck, ColourPop. This is Anastasia, and this is Line Crime. Now my drawers. God, it's gonna be so difficult. Okay, so this first drawer is like my nail polish, my emery boards. I have my Coty Airspun setting powder and my makeup wipes. I have some e.l.f. makeup wipes, Wet n Wild makeup wipes, and like this brand from TJ Maxx. I'm gonna speed this up a little so that you guys aren't sitting here for like years. Then right here I have some palettes and eyelashes and just random stuff. I have my Lime Crime Venus palette. I have my Anastasia Prism palette. A ColourPop All I See Is Magic palette. My Too Faced Cat Eyes palette. And this palette that I got in a BoxyCharm. Then back here, I just have some more palettes. I have the Wet n Wild Natural palette. It's a really good palette. I have three Sleek palettes. I have the, what's this one? I have the Sleek When the Sun Goes Down palette. Oh fuck, I'm dropping everything. But this is what the Sleek palette looks like. This is gross. This is like a gross video. I have the Ultra Matte palette by Sleek. One of the shades is broken, but don't mind that. They're just like bright colors. And then I have the Under a Spell palette by Sleek, which is my favorite out of the three. I love these colors so much. And then I just have my lashes. I don't have any high quality lashes because I'm cheap and I don't like spending more than $8 on eyelashes, to be quite honest. But I just have, oh my god, these are so dirty. Oh no, but I have these Kiss lashes, two pairs of LA Color lashes, that I got from like the Dollar Tree, two pairs of Ardell lashes, this pack of eyelashes that my friend got me for my birthday, and then this pack of eyelashes that I got from like TJ Maxx or something, I don't remember, but yeah, those are just my eyelashes. I don't have many, but I don't really wear false lashes as much, only when I want to make my, like, a dramatic look or whatever. I don't know. But, yeah. Then I just have, like, this little NYX Shadow Glitter Primer shit. But, yeah. Oh, my God. You guys can't even see this. Oh, my God. This is probably going to be gross quality, but whatever. I don't give a shit. Okay. So these are like my bigger palettes. I don't know. I have this palette that I got in a BoxyCharm. It's by Pure Cosmetics, and it's just a like highlight, contour, and blush, I guess. But like this contour is literally a highlighter, the blush is literally a highlighter, and the highlighter is literally a highlighter. So that's cool. I have my Pride and True Anastasia Beverly Hills Aurora Glow Kit. This makes me love my life, as you can probably already tell. It's my favorite thing to ever exist. I have a Pearl Fusion highlighter palette that I got from like Five Below. That's really good. I have this e.l.f. blush palette that I got from TJ Maxx for like $1, because I don't like spending money. And then I have these two Coastal Scents palettes. This one is the Fall Festival palette, which my friend has, and she recommended it to me. And even though I don't use it as much as I would want to, it's still a really good palette, and I got it on Amazon for like $12. And then I also have this Winterberry palette, also by Coastal Scents, which is a bunch of like purple frosty colors, which is really pretty, and I love life. Okay. Then I just have this little Wet n Wild pigment that I use for a highlighter, along with this one. And then another Real Techniques sponge. I have my favorite Violet Voss Pro palette that is literally the reason why I exist in life. I have this old ass blush palette that I got like 4 years ago. I have this BH Cosmetics Pro palette that I recently got like this month. I bought it for myself for my birthday. It reminds me of a Morphe palette, but it has a lot more colors, I think, than a Morphe palette, and the quality is a lot better than a Morphe palette, and it was, like, $21. Morphe palettes are, like, $31, so I saved a good $10. I have this J.Cat Beauty palette that I got. When did I even get this? I think I got this on Amazon. The pans are really, really, really big, and the quality is really, really good. I don't use it, but it came broken. Like, this is, like, broken off. But who cares? It's a really good palette. I appreciate its quality, and it was, like, $11, so can I really complain? I can't. I got this Bombshell Cosmetics palette from Five Below. That's extremely good, and it was $5. And the colors, like, do you see the colors? Like, I'm gonna swatch this top blue color, and you tell me you can be the verdict. Like, okay, $5. I see you, Anastasia Shook. And then I just have these two random old-ass BH Cosmetics palettes that I'd never use because they're old, and I have newer palettes that I want to appreciate and love and enjoy, so I don't really use them as often. And then over here, I have this random-ass Urban Decay palette that I got on Sephora because it was on sale, so I just got it. And then I have another Urban Decay palette, which is the Full Spectrum palette, but I don't feel like taking it out, so I'm not going to. That is literally all of my makeup. Wow, we're done. We are finished. Amazing. So that was all of my makeup. It's a mess. I should invest in some disinfectant because but yes, I hope you guys realize that I'm disgusting and I don't clean my makeup brushes. But I've been collecting makeup for the past, like, I just started really getting into makeup like the end of last year. Like, before that I was into makeup, but I didn't really care about it as much as I do now. I would like to be a cosmetologist in the future. Like, that'd be an amazing thing. But yes, this is my little makeup collection or whatever. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did enjoy, thanks. This is a random video that I'm making at 3 o'clock in the morning when I should be sleeping. That's why my sleeping schedule is fucked itself. But, thanks for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if you want to. And you should also, while you're at it, leave a comment down below and, what was I gonna say? Recommend, like, put down video recommendations, like, that you would want me to make in the future, and I will do it. My social media is in the description box down below. I follow back and add back everyone because I want to make friends, and I like people, so do that if you want to, and I'll see you guys on the flip side.